This demonstration here shows how much a dairy cow will eat in a week from the amount of corn, whole corn, ground corn, soybean, vitamins and mineral, cottonseed hulls, that much hay, and 50 gallons of water a day. And just a real good way to show people how much a dairy cow does consume. Timid. I don't know, those aren't button quail, I don't think. I think those are those other quail. Well, it gives people a chance to see a calf being born. One bushel of wheat makes 64 loaves of bread. And there, if you count them, there's 64 loaves of bread there on that display. And that's about 60 pounds of hard red spring wheat. It's a good way to show a non-farmer how many loaves of bread comes out of a bushel of wheat. And I think it's a little easier to explain the price of wheat when there's an increase in the price of bread. You don't blame it on the price of wheat. And over here is a bunch of different grains and different products made out of wheat and durum. Chicken that hatched out, a bunch of baby ducks, and raising the baby ducks. Thank you.
Hey girls, what you got?
I have a button quail, the smallest kind of quail in the world.
Wow, that is small.
What do you Mine have? Is a guinea hen.
Ooh.
It eats lots of bugs.
Okay.
Here you see it's
pie. Great. And what's yours?
Mine's a feral quail. What else?
It's about the same size as the button quail, but it gets a little bit bigger.
Okay, so it's the next size bit up. And these birds live at the Fargo Airport, right?
But the button quail lives in the castle.
And the button quail are in the castle. I already shot the castle. So there is the airport. Complete with Chicken Little skydiving.
Fargo, you should get it.
And Fargo Flight School. A 1,000-pound steer can produce 750 quarter-pounders. And there are the 750 boxes. Okay, this is a...
Poached.
Okay.
And then a silky.
A silky. Okay, thank you. This is the Halloween village, isn't it?
I'm gonna do the airport. Huh?
This is a little teaching area. How many boxes of cornflakes can you make out of a bushel of corn, and of course teaching what a bushel is.
This is the second smallest bird in the world. It's called a button quail.
And you said it's the second smallest?
Yeah.
Okay. How big do they get?
Well, they get about this tall.
That's called a button quail?
Yes.
Hey, thanks.
This is one of the kinds of quail that's getting hatched out. This is the feral quail. They get about the size of my fist. Right now they're just a little baby.
Oh, I see. There's a whole bunch of them.
Like it so well they climb up on their own.
This is the first peacock hatched at the Red River Valley Fair. It hatched on the second day of the fair.
How many birds hatch a day here?
Well, our goal is for 100 birds to get hatched a day, and we're over the goal a little bit. So we're getting about 110 birds hatched a day. From all sorts of quail to exotic pheasants, the peacock, guinea hens, ducks, and chickens.
Great. What geese?
Okay, these are some of the kids working, and they all have t-shirts with fun facts about agriculture on the back of their shirts.
Thank you.